right channel of 3-2-L test. Right channel of 3-2-L test.
Back then, Reagan is so smooth and effective a performer that he completely won over. American people. Only now, nearly 7 years later, are people beginning to question whether there's anything beneath that smile. Now that's not gonna sit well with the conservative base. In fact, when you look at Trump's record, not very much of it will sit well with the base at all. What he was saying at different times in his life depended completely on what suited his political needs at that time. In 1999, Trump actually left the Republican Party when he knew that George W. Bush was a lock for the GOP nomination. And at that point, he became a downright liberal. In 1999, he told Fox News Sunday, quote, "I'm totally pro-choice. I'm pro-choice because I think we have no choice." In his 2000 book, "That America We Deserve," he pushes for huge taxes on the wealthy, saying, quote, "By imposing a one-time 14.25% net worth tax on richest individuals and trusts, we can put America on sound financial footing for the next century." I'm not even that liberal. That's a giant tax increase that he advocated for back then. In the same book, he makes a case for a Canadian-style healthcare system. Quote, "We must have universal healthcare. The Canadian plan also helps Canadians live longer and healthier than Americans. We need, as a nation, to re-examine the single-payer plan." Okay, so that was him in 2000. But now that he can get people to angle over President Obama's universal healthcare plan, which, by the way, isn't even nearly universal enough, in my opinion, all of a sudden, Donald Trump, not so liberal.
"I want to make America healthy, and I want also want it to be affordable. Obamacare is a disaster. Number one, it's bad medical care. But almost as
important..." Hasn't gone into effect yet.
"Excuse me. It's a bad concept. But also, very importantly, this country can't afford it."
So, when your plan was 10 times as liberal, what happened? And how does he feel about raising taxes now that he's a born-again Republican?
"Would you raise taxes to protect the deficit?"
I don't think you have to. I'm interested. If we get this economy going, we can do it by getting jobs, by getting our jobs back. We're going to back. Let the other countries worry about themselves.
And how about abortion? Well, now he's pro-life. Well, of course he is. Not that he knows what that even means. Now, watch this cringeworthy moment in that same Savannah Guthrie.
"Is there a right to privacy in the Constitution?"
I guess there is.
So, how does that
work? Just out of curiosity, what do you expect?
Well, I'm just wondering how that squares with your pro-life.
Well, it's pretty strange where you're going to life. I mean, it's what it is to go to life. And why are you, what does that have to do with privacy? How are you avoiding pro-life with privacy?
Well, you know about the Roe v. Wade.
Yes, sure. Yeah, I'm for pro-life. I am pro-life.
Oh, well, that was painful to watch. Here's some help, Donald. The United States Supreme Court had earlier established the right to privacy and then applied that to the issue of abortion in Roe v. Wade. It is a central tenet that led to legalizing abortion. That's why they're mad. The fact that Trump doesn't know that is, as usual, embarrassing. And it's only matched by how embarrassing his overall opportunism is. How obvious is this guy? He has no principles or political beliefs at all. He's just trying to appeal to whichever crowd is in front of him. He's a classic carnival barker. Joining me now is political reporter for the Associated Press, Charles Babington. His new article is titled "GOP Voters in Early States Embrace Trump Bid." But Charles, it looks like, as you're reporting, the voters are eating it up. What's going on at the state level, for example, South Carolina, et cetera, in terms of reaction to Trump's campaign?
Yeah, well, I was calling Republican activists in South Carolina and Iowa, New Hampshire, the early voting states, and what I found was tremendous hunger on their part for somebody, almost anybody, who will go out there and go on television and really be forceful in attacking President Obama on health care and spending and debt and all those things. And what I found is that there's a void right now. It seems to be a vacuum, and to admit that Donald Trump is filling that vacuum, and they are happy to have it.
And is it about the birther issue, or is it something else that's driving them to Donald Trump?
Well, for quite a few of these activists, I found that they didn't much care about the birther issue. That wasn't very important to them, for some it was. But for the others, it was more the fact that Trump would get out there and really forcefully take quacks and Obama and the congressional Democrats. That's going to be the most important thing for them.
But Charles, you know, that's interesting because, you know, all these Republicans, all they ever do is take really forceful whacks at the president. I don't see many of them really taking it easy on the president. So I'm wondering, what is it? Is it is there an extra level of Trump that he's just rationally indicting the president at a whole level? I can't figure it out. It seems like they all don't like him.
Yeah, that's a good question. I think Trump, you know, he is flamboyant. He really gets attention on television. So he has a celebrity. He's very well known. And so, for example, even if Congressman like Paul Ryan, as you know, and your listeners know, is a very important member of Congress, the average American probably has not heard of him. So I think a lot of it's the celebrity factor. So Donald Trump, with a big name recognition, goes on television and says he really takes these hits at the president, and that seems to be firing off these Republican activists who are getting very hungry for that type of comments.
Charles, based on your reporting on local political leaders and the voters, et cetera, when the Republican leadership overall attacks them as they have over the last couple of days, are they risking alienating their own voters?
That's quite possible. I think this information about Trump's past that you've been going on over very heavily in your show here is something that's really come to the surface, at least at this level, quite recently. So when I was talking with these activists just a few days ago, they did not talk about these things. I'm not even sure they were aware of them.